In the past, droids such as R2-D2 and C-3PO from the Star Wars saga were regarded as science fiction. Now, robots with artificial intelligence, which can move autonomously and gather information through sensors, have long since found their way into the real world and science, also in agriculture and plant breeding. The farm droid is now making its rounds through rows of sugar beets. At half a kilometer an hour, it navigates the field sowing sugar beets. While sowing, the agricultural robot digitally registers the placement area of the seed. Based on the information regarding the plant's location, this allows it to mechanically remove weeds growing between the plants.
This is already the second year that we are testing robotic systems such as the farm droid for mechanical weed control in sugar beet. And our goal is to offer farmers perspectives for achieving sustainable weed control for sugar beet cultivation.
The trials are part of the digital experimentation field referred to as Farmer Space, which is funded by the Federal Ministry of Food and Agriculture. The analyses are conducted together with the University of Göttingen's Institute for Sugar Beet Research. The sensor technology plays a decisive role for precise weed control systems. Thus, robots of Farming Revolution use the information from cameras to remove weeds with rotary choppers. But not only autonomous robots use the most modern sensor technology and artificial intelligence. Even weed control tools pulled by tractors are employed in a targeted manner.
Modular systems, for example from Strothmann or also the Robovator, can handle up to 12 rows simultaneously, and thus they are achieving a greater capacity for covering larger areas. And this plays an important role in the profitability of mechanical weed control.
In terms of organic farming, mechanical weed removal with robots is compared to manual weed control using the hand hoe. Axel Altenweger is examining just how many hours of manual labor with the hand hoe can be saved and how difficult it is to integrate such systems into operations. As the head of operations of Klostergut Fiebershausen, he and his colleagues farm around 400 hectares of ecological trial and cultivation areas.
The main problem in the organic sugar beet production is the weed control in the row of the beets. There we have about 80 to 200 hours handwork, and we are searching for a system which helps us to control the weed in the row.
However, this would entail constantly aligning the systems according to the conditions on the field.
Robots like this can help us in the field work, but we need qualified personnel to control the robot.
The application of crop protection products is being increasingly strongly regulated to ensure greater sustainability, as well as climate and environmental protection in farming. This presents farmers throughout the world with major challenges. With a view to a possible reduction in the amount of crop protection products, innovations within the field of precision spraying are of particular interest. They are also being tested as part of the project.
Our trials with camera-based precision spraying systems, such as the EcoRobotics, show that these systems have the potential to highly reduce the amounts of herbicides when compared to conventional spraying systems.
None of the systems tested up until now are completely ready. However, they offer great promise for the future, especially in combination with other measures and technologies.
The various weed control systems that we are testing in our trials can contribute to make organic farming more profitable, but also lead to a reduction of plant protection agents in agriculture. These are important steps towards an approach to farming that is more sustainable and focuses on climate and environmental protection.